one click, donate, you know, 1 euro in order to fulfill one radio ad. I think that's a very good approach to potentially get some of this information out there, you know.
Excellent.
Thank you.
On St. Patrick's Day, actually, myself and another guy, we had a banner, and we walked into the parade. We walked towards the police, and we just acted confidently like we're part of the parade, and the police separated and let us walk through. We were walking down the road with the banner through the parade. And then later on, with the video cameras on St. Patrick's Day, we were getting our banner up on the TV. And we got a phone call later saying that they seen the banner on the TV for about 10 seconds.
Ah, great.
During St. Patrick's Day.
Right. That's brilliant. Well, that's the way to do it. I mean, be where the camera's at. And I mean, again, unfortunately, we are in that kind of climate right now where the majority are still looking at the mainstream media, so that's the way you gotta kind of peer through if you have an agenda like this that you wanna, you know, get the message out. So that's a great way to do it, actually.
And our documentary as well, it has consistently been among the most viewed for Google Ireland, so it's getting a huge number of views too. So I'm getting good feedback from the documentary. So that's another aspect of it as well. So we're trying to cover as many different angles as we can with this. So just to get the message out.
Indeed.
And let people know.
We're also having a screening of the movie End of Nations in Dublin, in a famous spot in Dublin, Temple Bar. We actually got a great deal on that. It's only, I think, about €340 to do a screening.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
You can charge in at the door. We're going to charge something very small, €3 a head. And from that €3, we're going to spend it all on flyers and they're going to help the campaign. So we should get about €700 from that, actually. And
very
if anybody
good.
Wants to go along, if anybody's listening in Ireland, it's on May 24th, it's Saturday, 11 a.m. at the IFI Temple Bar.
Very good. May the 24th. Remember that, and that's very good. And I mean, I think we'll do like this. I want to ask you guys if you'd be interested in coming back on this radio show sometime in either at the end of May or at the beginning of June. Do you think you guys will have time at that point to do that?
Yeah,
of course. Yeah. Maybe we can discuss the Laval judgment, how it's going to lower wages in the EU states.
Definitely.
Yeah, you must be very familiar with the Laval judgment in Sweden.
Yeah, I think Sweden and Denmark are one potentially those countries is going to be most hard hit by that. Isn't that right?
Yeah, well, in Ireland we have a minimum wage, which protects us a little bit, but it's going to be really bad for countries that don't have a minimum wage.
Oh my God! Yeah, it's one thing after the other. But again, I mean, I want to round things up here for this time, saying that you guys are doing a fantastic work over there. Keep it up, and again, get that donation page up on the website, and make sure to send that link along to me, and I'll do what I can from my end to get the message out. So I want to thank you both guys for getting on, but let's finish things off though. But mentioning your two websites again, We Are Change Ireland and also Wise Up Journal. Tell us a little bit about the websites and what people can find on there, guys.
Well, on Wise Up Journal, you can find information about health issues, freedom issues, and the global government scheme, the EU and Lisbon Treaty. There's lots of, and everything has links to real documents, and it's from newspapers around the world. There's no hearsay on it, and there's documentaries also to get people informed on what's going on.
Very good. And then there's the WAC Ireland, WeAreChangeIreland.org. That's the other site, and WiseUpJournal.com. That's another site. Thank you very much, guys, for coming on, and I'm looking forward to having you back on the program, and let's cover some of the other areas that we didn't have time for in this program, okay?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you for tuning in, and thanks to producer Fredrik behind the controls. We'll be back on Sunday with Ben, who's behind the film Esoteric Agenda. Until then, stay tuned to our website, redicecreations.com. This is Henrik Palmgren. Take good care, and we'll talk more soon.